Where are we going today?
We're going to Sequoia National Park. We're going to hike out a lodge pole, try and get up over Silliman Pass, and lodge at Ranger Lake.
How high is that pass?
At 10,100 and something.
So we're up over 10,000. We're up higher than Mount Baldy in the pass that we have to go over today.
We are. We're further north than Baldy, so hopefully the snow's not too bad, and we can get across this pass.
Excellent.
It'll be our first time into the
All right, here we are at Lodge Pole, getting ready to go up to Ranger Lake here in the Sierras with Ms. Fang North, and of course on Food Chain.
Back together again.
The return of Food Chain.
Yeah. So Keith, what kind of production is this?
This is a Food Chain production.
See, this is a Food Chain production, and we're gonna have a lot of fun. And I miss my hiking bud.
It's gonna be a bitchin' hike.
It's a glorious day.
Glorious day, uh-oh. All right, let's go. Now this is what I'm talking about. That's the Sierras. Okay, here at the trailhead, 10.1 miles, no problemo, huh?
Piece of cake for us.
Piece of cake, crampons, should be no problem. We're a little bit of a late start here, but yeah, should be no problem.
Should be.
We are going over a granite pass, 10,100 feet.
Yeah, granite pass, 10,100 feet with snow. Crampons. Now that is a view. Look at that. Look at that. Truly amazing. That's one thing the Sierra Nevada are. Beautiful, amazing, and awesome. Just feel so grateful to be out here hiking with Ms. Thang and North. We are having a blast. We're about 4 miles in to a 10-mile day up to Ranger Lake, maybe 5 miles in.
Was a cowboy I knew in South Texas. His face was burnt deep by the sun. Part history, part sage, part Mexican. He was there when Pancho Villa was young. And he'd tell you a tale of the old days, when the country was wild all around. Sit out under the stars of the Milky Way and listen while the coyotes howl. And they go, woo-yip, woo-yip, woo. Woo-loo-yip, woo-yip, woo-yip, woo. Woo-loo-yip, woo-yip. Now the longhorns are gone and the drove.
Why are you having fun, Thang?
Why am I having fun? Because I'm out here hiking with you guys.
You're out with Food Chain and North.
That's right, Food Chain and North.
Geronimo's gone and Sam Bass is gone and the lion is gone and the red wolf is gone.
That is a pretty big bear, Rob. This bear right here is a huge bear. This one's got some pretty big claw marks, no big deal. And then I looked up, and that's about 8 feet high right there. So, and the space between the claw marks, this bear that's making this mark, we're going through his territory right now, that's a pretty big bear. I mean, I'd say, as black bear goes, they don't really get any bigger than that. That's a very big, big bear.
Only he could see. He'd say all that's left now of the old days, damned old coyotes and me. And they'd go, ooh-yip, ooh-yip, ooh. Ooh-loo-yip, ooh-yip, ooh. Ooh-yip, ooh-yip, ooh. Ooh-loo-yip. Now the longhorns are gone, and the drovers are gone, the Comanches are gone, the outlaws are gone, now Quantro's gone. Stand watch.
What do you think about that?
Pretty bitchy. Not bad at all.
We have some deep snow up here now. We're 5 foot snowdrift.
One morning they searched his adobe. He disappeared without even a word. But that night as the moon crossed the mountain, one more coyote was heard. And he'd go, ooh-yip, ooh-yip, ooh. Ooh-loo-yip, ooh-yip. Ooh,
one of the Twin Lakes after walking through snow all day. Truly amazing. As beautiful as you can get. I mean, this is the most amazing, most beautiful location that I've hiked into in 2014. And if you look up here, across the lake, there's a giant waterfall that comes down this granite cliffs. Truly amazing. What do you think, Bang?
Absolutely amazing. I'm your family.
All right, we just bushwhacked coming up above Twin Lake. We're coming up this way here. Because who knows where the trail is, but we knew we would hit it. We saw some cut logs that had washed down. And you can see right here, this is definitely trail work. There's a switch back here, so we're definitely on trail. And it looks like, because we're kind of southerly facing, that we'll be out of the snow for the first time in about 6 miles. So that's pretty good. Now that's awesome. Okay, we are just coming up on 10,000 feet right now. Above Twin Lakes and above Ranger Lake, which is on the other side of the pass here. We've decided basically just to come up the Collier here and cut the switchbacks that go back and forth to save a little bit of time. It's coming up on 5 o'clock. We got a little late start and we've traversed now through about at least 8 miles of snow. But we're making good progress and the views have been spectacular. Sunset just blew up. It just blew up. Look at that. Got some awesome pictures of it. Insane. Insanely beautiful here at over 10,000 feet between Ranger Lake and behind me down here where the sunset are the Twin Lakes. Unbelievable. Camped out on the saddle between Ranger Lake and Twin Lakes at an altitude of about 10,000 feet, maybe a little more than 10,000 feet, a little higher than Mount Baldy in the San Gabriel Range. We are camped on the snow. This is a snow camp. And temperatures drop pretty quick. It's about 30 degrees. So, I mean, not terrible, but, you know, getting cold. But we had a blast today. Miss Thang, North, and I just had a great hike. We're the only ones up here. There were no other tracks in the snow whatsoever. No snowshoes, no nothing. So as far as I know, we're the first ones up here this season. Maybe the only people up here since last fall. So pretty awesome. But I got some great pictures of the sunset. And I'm going to try to get some great pictures of the sunrise tomorrow morning. We'll see. And I want to give a shout out to my friend John Morisano and Chris Safford, who just finished Section A, the PCT today. I can't wait to see the video, John, and I miss you guys. We got to do a trek soon, and that's it.
hopefully no bears tonight.
So North, how did you sleep?
Slept good, like a baby, nice and warm and toasty in there.
Nothing like a good night's sleep at 10,000 feet, huh?
You have to have a good night's sleep at 10,000 feet.
How did you sleep last night?
Very good. It was nice and warm.
Yeah?
It was nice and warm, and
it's always nice to get a good night's sleep at 10,000 feet?
Yes, it's very nice to get a good night's sleep at 10,000 feet.
Friday morning, day two, we're going to be heading back down today. We're going to be breaking camp here in a little bit. It's about 7 a.m., but these views are truly out of this world. Truly out of this world. And our camp is right on the ridge back, right beyond these trees. What a great night. Relatively warm, you know, I'd say low 30s, high 20s, no wind. I mean, just perfect conditions, perfect conditions. But what an awesome morning. What an awesome morning. This is looking back towards Visalia and the San Joaquin Valley back that way. And then coming over here, Whitney's up there. And then all of these other 12,000, 13,000 footers. And this monstrosity over there. I mean, just truly awesome. What a morning. To be up here in the High Sierras on a Friday morning, I just feel so lucky and privileged. You can't beat this, that's for sure. Anyway, I'm gonna go back down, break camp. Gonna head back down and call it a day. Good morning. All right, we just broke camp up here on the saddle between Ranger Lake and Twin Lakes. And we're going to head down off this mountain. We had a great night last night, huh?
Great.
Everybody was warm.
Wahoo!
Woohoo! And we got about 8 miles back to the car. I'm guessing about 5,000 foot drop. I'm not sure. It doesn't really matter. Going to stop and pump water probably down near Twin Lakes, or there's like numerous streams of pure, clean, you know, snow melt. So. Let's go!
Mine.
Look at that Sierra snow melt. That is awesome. Whoa! Now that's insane. Hey, had a marvelous hike, about a total out and back of about 20 miles, good 10, maybe more miles of snow traverse. We camped at Silliman Pass up around 10,000 feet in elevation last night, and it was perfect weather. It's perfect down here in the bottom as well. There are no bugs. It's still early enough in the season, no mosquitoes, no gnats. We had a great time. We had numerous stream crossings. I still have one more before I get back to the parking lot. But nobody fell in, no problem. A couple of the dangers are snow bridges over the streams, but we didn't encounter too many of those. So pretty good. We had a great time. Some bear sign, we saw some bear signs, some pretty big bear tracks. But I mean, it's the Sierra Nevada, so I mean, they're up here all the time. It's just part of the beauty up here. And personally, I love the bears. That was a magnificent backpack, was it?
It was a fantastic trip.
Camping at Silliman Pass at 10,000 feet, you know, out and back, probably about 18 miles as far as we went.
Yeah.
And about 12 of those miles snow, and just had a magnificent time. I mean, another awesome adventure with the adventure hikers.
Mm-hmm. Whoa-ho!
Woohoo!
And he tell you a tale. When the country was wild all around, sit out under the stars of the Milky Way and listen while the coyotes howl. And they go, woo, yip, woo, yip, woo. Woo-da-loo, yip, woo, woo, woo. Woo, yip, woo, yip, woo. Woo-da-loo, yip, woo, woo, yip, woo.
And I have to put my tent away from you guys because I snore. But tonight you're going to get video of me actually. You got to prove it to me that I snore that loud. I know I snore.
Fang snores. She sounds like a angry bear. That's what she does.
You think there's a bear outside.
Snore for me. Make the noise.
I don't know how I snore. I don't know how to snore unless I'm asleep.
Fang does snore and it is loud. My God, we don't have to worry about a bear coming through our camp at night.
You snore too.
Oh, I don't snore.
Shit, I'm perfectly quiet. You snore.
How would you know? We can't hear him over your snoring.
Yeah. Hey! Don't get after me. You guys, never mind.
He what?
We won't gang up on you.
He what? He what?
He dumps piss out of his tent in the middle of the night, right outside of it.
Did you dump this jug outside your tent?
I have.
Okay, see, we don't want Dorothy. Dorothy, you'll never see this.